what's up? This is Ian Robinson here in front of the Soho Apple Store. Yes, that's right. Nirvana for the Macheads like myself. Now, I'm sure you've heard the buzz. There's something big going on. It's involving music and Apple. What could it be? Could Apple be helping to bridge the chasm between the music industry and high tech? Well, if anybody can do it, we all know Apple can. You want to know more?
Hold it. Let's go straight
to number one.
I mean, these are the people that changed my life with the simple invention of the iPod. There is no way they can't kick the hell out of whatever else is going on out there. I mean, it's no wonder the music industry is in such a slump. For example, Kazaa, well, sorry kids, that's stealing, it's not really sharing. And as far as these subscription services go, well, that doesn't make a lot of sense to me either. You rent an apartment, you don't rent music. There has to be a better way. I mean, there's gotta be. Yes, there is a better way, and of course, Apple has nailed it. I cannot wait to show you this. It is so cool. Right there in your iTunes, you see a new button, a special button. What does it do? Don't be afraid. Follow me down the rabbit hole, Alice. You click on it, and dun, 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 the iTunes Music Store. This is a real music store. You go in, you search around, you find your favorite artist, and you buy music for 99 cents a song. Let's check out Sum 41, see what all we can find here. Ooh, that's good. When I double click on it, ho-ho, it previews 30 seconds of music, and it's free. Oh yeah, plays instantly. And instantly is so much better than waiting in line. Oh yeah, this is the rock. This is what I need. And it's so simple to buy. You just run over here, you click this, boom. Easiest thing in the world. Buy a song or a whole album. Either way, you get album art. Awesome. Sometimes you gotta go places, work, school, whatever, and you wanna bring your music with you. You can burn CDs of your songs as many times as you want for yourself. Or you can do the best thing ever, which is to transfer them to the iPod. As many as you want. Ooh, that's right. The new one. The new iPod. 30 gigs. How many songs is that? Do the math quickly in your head. 7,500 songs. This is what we live life for. And what's great is that I get to keep this, right? I can keep it. What do you mean, no?
To number one.
Okay, let me see if I've got this straight. I can burn in the fiery damnation of hell for stealing music, or joy, I can get in my car, drive to a store, deal with humans, and a cashier to buy a CD with maybe two songs I like on it for 20 bucks. Yay! Or the iTunes Music Store. I can click around, I could buy just the two songs I want, 99 cents a piece, or I can buy the whole album. That quick, I own it, it's mine, forever.
Of course I'm interested in iTunes. Technology has been at the very, very heart of rock and roll. Going back to Jimi Hendrix stepping on a fuzz box. At the start of the 21st century, we're watching new technologies emerging, and people are going to be able to get closer to the music and closer to the people who make it through these new technologies, and I welcome them.
The Apple Music Store is great for artists because you don't have to worry about your albums going out of print, and you don't have to worry about the store space and the shelf space. People can get to your music immediately, and that's the thing that most of musicians are most concerned about.
I'm very excited about the iTunes Music Store because of the options that are being given. I'm a huge advocate of choice, and to allow that visceral response to a song to be gratified as instantly as possible, I give the big thumbs up to.
I love the iPod. Technology doesn't, we kind of equate that with science, or it doesn't have to be cold and ugly. It can be something beautiful and just magnificent and wondrous.
I do not want to have a doctorate, a PhD in button pushing to be able to get to the Clash. Apple people have been making objects that we, musicians, and not just musicians, but filmmakers and people, creative people, have been using for a long time because you're friendly, because you get it. And so there's a nice rhyme in the fact that you have been coming up with a solution that will help us in the pursuit of our work. Thank you.
What I love about this iTunes Music Store idea is that there's a concern for artists, a concern for protection, a concern for evolution, a concern for people getting music right away. So everyone's being taken into account, and no one's really being left behind. And that's the ultimate convergence of technological evolution and spiritual consideration. That's what I'm all about, so that's why I get excited.
And I'm all about the rock and roll. This is Ian Robinson signing off. Stay metal. Don't forget to check out the iTunes Music Store. It rocks. Trust me, I wouldn't lie to you.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Hold it. Let's go straight
to number one.